Project management is something which touches everyone, whether their projects are small or they are big or they are mega projects. And there are many factors which relate to the project. India is growing, so obviously when you talk about growth, projects are always there. And nothing new that the projects are growing in size, in complexities, and hence we need lots of new tools, new education, learning, which is definitely needed to reduce the cost and make the projects work on time. This theme of cost overrun or increase in cost is actually one of the six important measurable parameters when you handle the project. First is always the delivery, because that's the most important part. Everybody can measure that. Deadlines and dates are all fixed. Second is quality, which is also measured regularly and by the authorized people who understand what quality is all about. So they keep checking that, and at the end of it, the customer needs to be very happy about the quality what is delivered in the project. The third is the cost. I think that's the most important parameter, and in fact there are methods of identification of how to crash activities to either reduce the cost or increase the cost. But sometimes you increase the cost because there is a return bonus which is available, and that bonus sometimes makes a big incentive to increase the cost and make the project finish early, because the cost of losing time is more important than cost of incurring expenses to reduce the time. So I think there's a good balance between the two. The fourth one is customer satisfaction, and I think at all the time, if the customer expects how you are responding or the other project team is responding to various needs which are not anticipated when the project was conceived but subsequently added, and one has to change many changes to make it happen so that the customers are by and large satisfied. So there are response, there are issues, there are changes, there are relationships which are involved. The fifth and most neglected area sometimes I feel is safety, because what happens is there are many accidents on the sites when projects are executed, and particularly those which relate to a lot of labor. So I think this area is particularly very vital and important, and you would have seen in metro there have been accidents and they affected in the newspaper, and to control those accidents or to control that news, I think is very, very vital, because on the morale of the people who are working in the team, and hence the impact of that. And the last is the ease of working. No, all the project can be done with 24 hours working. Each person is stretching himself for many, many hours, then what 8 hours mandatory are needed. So question comes in is how beautiful the planning has been done, that there is no overstretch. The rework is minimized. And the rework is the most expensive part of the cost. And if one can plan extremely well, the cost substantially can be reduced, because rework adds to a huge cost. Good old days, when we were running projects, I think the only tool which we knew was per sheet, and understanding, not many people could understand. I was in telco, and very, very senior person, Mr. Kulkarni, was the head of construction division, a lot of activities happening in Pune. And our director, general manager, wanted to know what is the progress and whether the project will be done on time or not. And he had no clue about how to analyze the critical path. And fortunately, I was trained in this part, and I drew a complete network for him, and drew for him, you know, what is the critical path, and how should he manage to keep track of that critical path so that the project gets on time. And he was so impressed that he continued to calling me every time the project was there. So youngsters learn a lot. People who get older will probably get dated, and obviously they don't have the knowledge, and people like us are always interested in learning a lot more than what we have learnt in our colleges, and keeping up to date is very, very vital and important. I was just talking to Commander Jaitley, and he said, you know, that if you have been executing projects of 100 crores or 150 crores or something like that, which, I mean, it keeps happening every now and then. So have you ever used our training to see that how much cost can you reduce? They said, yes, we have been always training our people in MS projects. But he said, no, that's not sufficient, because unless you change the mindset, there is no question of using the MS project. So MS project is a very good tool, but you need the most important tool, which is a human being, to change along with that. So I think we always thought that we knew about it, but we always learn something new. So that's a very interesting part of the game today. Now, last parameter, which is always is how to manage. I mean, MS Project still does tell you how to manage the project, but how to manage interface, which is very, very important in the whole game. As you go to a large and larger project from mega projects, there are many, many teams which are participating, and sometimes they are independent entities, and lots of egos, lots of silos, and they don't interface with each other. And because they don't interface with each other, there is a lot of rework which gets created. I mean, most recent example is any beautiful road you see is made, and you are driving on the first day on that road, you are so happy. But next 3 days, 4 days, or maybe in a few months, you will see a lot of digging happens on that road. Somebody is putting the pipeline, somebody is putting electrical line, somebody is putting something. Net result is that the beautiful road is damaged, and it sends its garments. Nobody bothers. Same thing happens on many, many projects. I'm taking Reliance in the refinery project. I mean, there are put about some 100 teams which are operating simultaneously. We call it engineering, simultaneous engineering, and it's very important that everybody, that the chief coordinator is able to coordinate all the activities of all the teams so that they don't have any lack of information and there is no crash or conflict in any of the issues which are coming continuously. To my experience, I have realized that this is one of the most important factors of how to manage projects very effectively, if you can manage the teams very effectively and then connection it between them so that they are on the same integrated model. Now that interface, the tools will tell you that there is a crash, there is a conflict, but the question comes in, the leader has to manage the human part of it, which is very, very vital. And I think all the project managers must get properly trained on human management, because that's something which actually is responsible for the doom of any of the projects. The last part which I felt always was the planning. What I learned in Japan when I was there in 1985 was that were excellent planning, and they would always take a lot more time on planning, but they go so much into detailed planning that there is very little scope of any change subsequently. All the likely, I mean, it's a very proactive approach, all likely failures they analyze well in time, they plan for those failures, and then they know that in case this happens, then this is the answer. They don't start looking for answers at that particular time. So that, I think, I found in Japanese projects when they were doing it, I think one of the biggest learning was their meticulous planning. And in India, I have not seen people doing so meticulous planning. It's a very superficial planning which is done on the surface. And then as and when we reach so-called the rivers and the bridges made, and then you cross the bridge, and it takes time. So there is a big loss of time. And I think these two factors of human interface and very detailed planning with proactive approach, I think I've seen these two areas which have a huge impact on cost overruns or finishing the projects well in time. So I won't take much of your time, and I again thank very much to this whole team of Asterix that I'm here today, and opportunity to learn to learned speakers of how things are being done differently. And along with you, I would be very happy to learn. Thank you very much.